Good afternoon. Class 9 to 10, Unit 2, Force. But it is related to not only 9 to 10, it is also related to class 8. Question number 1. Why does a rifle recoil on firing a bullet from it? The answer is, it is related to Newton's third law of motion. On firing a bullet from a rifle or gun, this bullet goes forward with a certain force. It goes forward with a certain force in one direction. That is called action. According to Newton's third law of motion, the rifle recoils with the same or equal force, that is reaction. Action and reaction are always equal and opposite. In the same way, rocket launching, swimming, walking also depend upon are related to Newton's third law of motion. Another question, question number 2, numerical problems in MGS system. Solve the numericals of vehicle of mass 5 quintals and acceleration 0.5 meter per second square starts to move from rest. How long does it travel in 2 minutes and what will be its velocity in that time? Solution is this: a vehicle of mass m 5 quintals equal 500 kg starts to move from rest. Initial velocity u equals 0, t time 2 minutes, 2 into 60, 120 seconds. How far will it go in 2 minutes? And what will be its final velocity? We know v equal u plus at, u 0, a. A is also given, a 0.5, acceleration 0.5 meter per second square, v equal u plus at, 0.5 into 120, 60 meter. Per second is the final velocity of the body. Mass given, acceleration given, initial velocity given, zero, time given, minute into second. B, final velocity is u plus at, 0 plus a, 0.5, t, 120 multiply 60 meter per second. S equal B plus U by 2 into T. B, final velocity is 60. Initial velocity 0. In time 2 minutes, 120 seconds. 60 into 120 by 2, 60. 3600 meter. So, the final velocity is 60 meter per second. And distance travel is 3600 meter or 3.6 kilometer. Again, multiply in this way. Next question, question number B, I have written one question. An object is projected vertically upwards with a uniform velocity. Uniform velocity of 19.6 meter per second. Find the maximum height it ascends and the time taken to reach that height. The problem is it is related to Newton's third law of motion. Upward motion. See, when a body is projected vertically upwards, what happens in the upward motion? You write upward motion initial velocity 19.6 meter per second. G minus 9.8 meter per second. Why? Because it is upwards. The acceleration due to gravity goes on decreasing. So minus. So at the maximum height, zero. At maximum height, when the body goes up, up and up, at last the final velocity is zero. And what is the maximum height and what is the time? We know h equal b square minus u square by twice g. B is zero minus 19.6 into minus 9.8. By calculation it is 19.6 meter. The object goes 19.6 meter up and it stops and again it falls down. What is the time taken? B minus u by g. B is 0 minus u 19.6, g minus 9.8. By calculation it is 2 seconds. The body, the object takes 2 seconds to reach the maximum height. Mahathir Phalda, u initial velocity given, g ko value minus 9.8 huncha up ma, maximum height ma, final velocity be 0 huncha, h what? H equal b square minus u square by twice g. Instead of a, you write g. Acceleration due to gravity minus 9.8, 19.6 meter. Time taken is b minus u by g, b minus u by g, 2 seconds. In the same way, you can solve another problem. An object falls and reaches the ground in 10 seconds. What should be given? U 0, time taken is 10, g equal 9.8 or 10. How to find the height? What is the solution? It is called downward motion. Downward motion by u equal 0. See, at 0, then it falls down. It is 0 and it comes down with the uniform acceleration. The uniform acceleration g is 9.8 meter per second square, and after t equal 10 seconds, the body falls from A to B in just 10 seconds. Then what is the height? H equal what? We know H equal ut plus half gt square. U is 0, time taken 10. Half 9.8 into 10 square. See, u into 0 into 10, 0 is cancelled. 4.9 into 100, 490. 90 meters. So from A to B, when it takes 10 seconds, it covers 490 meters during the downward motion. Now, you should know Subhas formula. Another question, question number 3, distinguish. First of all, I write scalar and vector. Scalar vector. Don't write, write. I'll write simple and short sentences, not very long sentences. Scalar. It has only a magnitude, but no direction. It has both a magnitude and a direction. It's a value unsa, direction undera, it's a value or the magnitude pani unsa, direction east, west, north, south pani unsa. See, scalar, it is always positive. That means when you add two or more scalars, the sum is always and always positive. It may be positive, negative, or zero. Example of scalar: mass, area, time, length, speed, distance, heat, volume, etc. But here, example of vector quantity: force, weight, velocity, displacement, momentum, but not moment, momentum, magnetic field intensity. So I'll say the summary. Scalar, it has only magnitude, no direction. Vector, both magnitude and direction. Scalar is always positive. The sum of two or more scalars is always positive. The sum of two or more vectors is positive, negative, or zero. Example: mass, area, time, length, speed, distance, heat, volume, etc., current, etc. Example of vectors: force, it needs direction, weight, velocity, displacement, momentum, magnetic field intensity. These quantities need a certain direction. B number. B number is generally speed and velocity. Many students are confused. In Nepali, it is called beg. It's called gati. They are similar, but not the same. It is the rate of distance in any direction. Speed has no direction. It is the rate of displacement in a fixed or particular direction. Rate of distance, rate of displacement. Speed, it is scalar and always positive. It is vector it is a vector and may be positive, negative or zero sometime. I'll give one example. Here one example, 90 kilometer per hour is unknown speed. Here I write 90 kilometer per hour due east or upwards. 90 kilo, see, speed, rate of distance, always positive, scalar. Rate of displacement, positive, negative or zero. It is a vector. Example, 90 kilometer per hour. Measurement and unit here, 90 kilometer per hour. Due east, due west, east, west, north, south, northeast, north, southeast, southwest, up, down. Direction is needed. Magnitude, unit, and direction all are needed in a velocity. C number, uniform velocity and variable velocity. Here, see there is only one, the body travels equal distance in equal intervals of time. The uniform velocity is the velocity of a body which travels equal distance in equal intervals of time. When the time increases, the distance increases, or velocity increases at the same rate. Same time, same distance. But here, the body travels different distance or different distances in equal intervals of time. Even if the time is same, but the body travels different distances. Example of uniform velocity, rotation and revolution of planets. Another, motion of vehicles running along a well surfaced straight road on the same gear ma ek nas le gairheko cha bhane yo uniform motion ho. Motion of the fan, motion of motor, etc. are also some examples of uniform marching of soldiers. Here example of this one is motion of birds, insects, people or animals, and another, vertically projected object, falling object, etc. Falling objects, what called the eye ago, vertically upward, mastery going ago, motion of birds, insects, people walking here and there, also variable motion. Variable motion is also called non-uniform motion. See, D number is distance and displacement. It is related to both 9 and 8 both of distance. It is the actual length covered by a body, that is moving body. It is the shortest length between the initial position and the final position of a body. L is distance. It is scalar and always positive. It is vector and may be positive, negative, or zero. Distance, actual length covered by a body, you have to measure all the distances, all the actual length here, displacement, first position and last position, just like vector quantity. It is always positive, but displacement is sometimes positive, sometimes negative, sometimes zero. Another, which is easy but sometimes asked, E number is relative velocity and average velocity. Average velocity. What is relative velocity and what is average velocity? It was a price associated. Relative velocity. It is the velocity of a body relative to another. Duita body ko, euta body ko arko body sabaiko velocity ko average cha. It is the velocity of a body relative to another. Arko sanga compare gareko. What is average velocity? It is the total distance covered by a body per second. Velocity, it is found by what? Relative velocity equal v minus u in the same direction. And relative velocity is e plus u in the opposite directions. Its formula is average velocity is given by total distance by total time. See, relative velocity of a body with respect to another body. Formula, relative velocity is v minus u in the same direction, v plus u in the opposite direction. Average velocity, total distance covered by a body in total time. Total distance kati huncha mathi lekhne, total time tala lekhne. Sometimes fast speed, sometimes low huncha, sometimes high huncha. So total distance by total time. Another, this is maybe the, possibly the last today, is speed and acceleration. If velocity and acceleration one bhane, velocity vector, acceleration vector, tyo nalekhne, same bhayeko nalekhne, different bhayeko matrai lekhne. Speed and acceleration, it is the rate of distance in any direction. Number one, what is this? It is the rate of increase in velocity. Oh yeah, acceleration, yeah, retardation somebody. Acceleration, rate of increase in velocity, retardation or deceleration is rate of decrease in velocity. Oh yeah, speed sum, isn't it? It is a scalar and is always positive. It is always positive. Speed is given by either s by t, uniform motion, or v equal u plus a t in a particular direction. Here it is a vector quantity, vector, and another is its SI or units are not only SI unit, meter per second, centimeter per second, feet per second, kilometer per hour, mile per hour. It is a vector quantity, but it is also positive. Its SI unit is not only unit, SI, not only SI unit, its units are centimeter per second square, CGS, meter per second square, SI, feet per second square, FPS system. See, you write SI unit of speed, meter per second, centimeter per second, feet per second, kilometer per hour, mile per hour, sometimes mile per minute also. SI units are centimeter per second square, CGS, meter per second square, FPS, feet per second square in SI system. When you go to a college or man, nobody, feet per second square, centimeter per second square. Small, by the way, your acceleration go unit. Speed go unit.